Sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what we have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak out, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to the Lord's word is, my soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you.
Thank you.
bless you all my life. In your name I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled with a banquet. With joyful lips my mouth shall praise you.
Reading from the letter of Paul, St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia.
God is good
all the time.
There were these two women who had two different kinds of troubles, or I can say they had different crosses, but they met coincidentally together at a river, a big river, with one agenda: to take away their lives. So this one of the women came there and found this other one seated next to the river. Then she asked her, "What are you doing here?" And she said, "I have come here to take away my life." I said, "Why?" And she said, "I have two children, and they are horrible. I don't know why God gave me. So they have been frustrating me, so I've decided to take away my life." Then she turned to her and then said, "What about you? What have you come to do here?" She said, "I've also come to take away my life." She said, "Why?" She said, I am childless. I've been asking God to give me a child, but no, none so far. So I'm frustrated. I want to take away my life." So this other woman said, No. Those two kids who are horrible, give them to me." So they never took away their lives. They went back. I would like us to reflect today on the crosses in our lives and what we do with them. Today's gospel passage is a continuation of last Sunday's, which highlighted the profession of faith of Peter, the rock upon which Jesus wishes to build his church. Today, St. Matthew shows us the reaction of the same Peter when Jesus reveals to his disciples that he will have to suffer, be killed, and rise again. What does Peter do? He takes Jesus aside and reproaches him. He says, "No, that is not going to happen." Then Jesus in turn rebukes Peter with very harsh words. He says, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a hindrance to me, for you are not on the side of God, but of men." I want us to realize something here. The Greek word for hindrance is skandalon. We get the English word scandal from that. So what Jesus is telling Peter is that you are a scandal to me. Now, what is interesting about that is that in the original Greek, the word scandalon literally means a stumbling stone. So a scandalon would be a stone on the path that you would trip over when you are walking. So Peter is still the rock, but is taken in a different form here. So we can ask ourselves, why would Jesus speak so harshly to Peter? Why is he saying these things about him? Get behind me, Satan. Well, because Jesus, as the divine Son of God, has come into the world to save the world through the redemptive suffering of his cross. And to the extent that Peter opposes the idea of Jesus suffering, and dying, he is opposing the salvation of the world. He opposes the way that God has chosen to redeem the world, to set it free from sin and death. So in a sense, Peter is also opposing the resurrection, because that is going to be the ultimate consequence of Jesus' passion and his death. Now, at that point, Jesus turns to those who are following him, clearly presenting to them the path to follow. And he says, if any man would like to come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. Deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. What does that mean? During those days, the cross was the most brutal and the most shameful way of execution. So it would be like saying, take up your electric chair and follow me. So you can compare, take up your electric chair and follow me. So it was that tough. Today too, the temptation is that of wanting to follow Christ without the cross. Say, no, that's not going to happen. We have that big temptation to follow Christ, but without the cross. But Jesus reminds us that his way is the way of love, and that there is no true love without self-sacrifice. So everybody in the world, including ourselves here today, have a cross to carry. It could either be physical, emotional, financial, personal, psychological, name them. So the issue is, what do we do with that cross? Do I deny it? Do I rebel against it? Do I kick it away? Do I curse it? Do I curse? Or do we numb ourselves with addictive substances to make us forget? Or do we take up and follow the Lord with it? St. Rose of Lima said that there is no other ladder to heaven, climbing up heaven, other than the ladder of the cross. So there is no ladder up to heaven other than the ladder of the cross. So ask yourself today, what are the crosses in my life? Am I willing to take up my cross? And am I willing to follow? So during this Mass, let our sharing in the Holy Eucharist strengthen us as we take up our crosses and follow Christ. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us now arise and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us now present our prayers and our petitions to the Lord.
For our church, Pope Francis, and all leaders, may we be people of prayer as we seek God's help during these troubled times. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people everywhere who are suffering from violence and natural disasters, for the victims of the coronavirus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families who are making important decisions and for the safety of our children, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, those in our hospitals and nursing facilities, the caregivers, and especially those working to end the coronavirus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering from poverty, especially the homeless and forgotten, those without adequate medical care, and all who are lonely, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, our sister parish, our prayer line intentions, and our beloved dead, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pat Shannon, for whom this Mass is celebrated, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us now turn to the intercession of our dear Mother Mary as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of our soul. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
true, right, and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you have loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my home, but only say the word and my soul shall be.
Those who are receiving communion, please remain standing in your pew. If you are not receiving communion, please be seated. The priest will come to you. Keep your nose and mouth covered except when consuming the host. Thank you.
You dwell in
Just a couple of announcements this week. This past week, all registered St. Ambrose parishioners should have received a parish newsletter with current happenings and the financial summary for financial year July 1, 2019 to June 30th, 2020. If you did not receive a newsletter and are a registered parishioner, please notify the rectory office with your correct address. If you are not registered, we encourage you to register. The newsletter is also available on the parish website. During the month of September, we will be participating in the Bishop's Annual Appeal. The current parish newsletter and bulletin contains some information. Complete information will be mailed from the Bishop's office in mid-September. We ask that you prayerfully consider how you can financially support your Bishop, the Diocese of Kalamazoo, and St. Ambrose Parish. Wishing you a very blessed weekend. Just want to remind you of the dismissal procedures. The priests will recess as usual. Please remain in your seat until an usher releases your row to exit. This will begin from the rear as usual. Please maintain social distancing as you exit the building, and please do not gather in groups outside. Thank you.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, O Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. May Almighty God bless and protect you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed weekend.
Thank you.